In this gospel snippet, I want to spend a few minutes speaking about the episode in Numbers chapter 21, when Israel, passing through the wilderness, rebelled against God, and he sent a plague of snakes among them. And all who were bitten by the snake died, and they were falling like flies. Thousands were dying. But God, in his mercy, said to Moses, "If you will make a snake out of brass and put it on a pole and lift the pole up, every Israelite that looks to that snake will be delivered." And Moses did so. And all the Israelites who looked to the brass snake were delivered and did not die. Of course, all who refused, thought it was ridiculous or turned away or whatever, perished. Now, however does this represent the gospel or shadow the gospel? Well, the Lord Jesus Christ made it very clear. John chapter 3, verses 14 and 15. "Just as Moses lifted up the serpent or the snake in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever looks to him, believes, trusts, calls upon him, shall be saved." He's speaking about himself. And John chapter 12 makes it very clear that he's speaking about his death. In the death of the Lord Jesus Christ, he being lifted up literally on the cross, he accomplished a redemption for sinners. And all who look to him by faith, and all who trust him, and all who call upon him, will be washed from their sins in his blood and delivered from the plague, the condemnation of sin, and the wrath of God. I also believe that Christ being lifted up speaks of the preaching of the cross. Christ crucified. Paul said, "I am determined to know nothing else but Jesus Christ and him crucified." And I, in my small way, am now lifting up Christ, saying that any sinner, every sinner who looks to the Lord Jesus, calls upon him, will be washed in his precious blood and clothed in his righteousness, delivered from the wrath of God, and presented faultless before God in Christ. And just as in the wilderness, all who looked and all were delivered who did look, so now all who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. But of course, those who refuse will perish. Now let me drop the third person. I speak to you, my friend. If you will call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, if you will trust in his finished work, if you will look to Christ on the cross, not literally, but spiritually, by faith, and trust in his precious blood to wash you from your sins and his righteousness to clothe you, I assure you on the basis of the word of God, all who look to Christ, as he himself says, he who believes will be saved. So that is what I present to you. But I do more than that. I urge you to call upon the name of the Lord. You are under the wrath of God. You are dead in your sins. You're under that dreadful plague. And you will perish forever unless you so call upon the name of the Lord. So I urge you, look to the crucified Lord Jesus Christ. Look now, trust him, call upon him, and you will be saved. I urge you not to brush this aside, but look to Jesus now. Look to him in faith, call upon his name, and be saved and saved forever. Please, I urge you. Listen to this and act upon it and do it now.